there, I'm Sankhita and welcome to Vertical Dots Writing Series. In this Premiere Pro tutorial, learn 10 more keyboard shortcuts and tips that you must know for faster writing. This is the second part of keyboard shortcuts and tips video series. If you haven't watched part 1, then you should definitely check it out. I have put the link below in the description. For now, let's get started with the new tips. First, we will talk about set to frame size. This one is very useful when you have different video sizes. Like here, my sequence size is 1920 by 1080. And if I want to use this shot, it's a 4K video. Video size is 3840 by 2160. So, if I put it on the timeline, it will look zoomed in. To make it to fit to your frame, you will have to right click here and then click on set to frame size. Rather than doing this, you can assign a keyboard shortcut for it, because there is no default keyboard shortcut is assigned for this one. Go to edit, click on keyboard shortcuts and look for set to frame size. And you can see there is no shortcut key is assigned for this one. So you can assign any key you want. If you see my custom layout, I have assigned Shift plus X for it. After you are done, click on OK. So whenever I have different video sizes, I just hit Shift plus X to set it to frame size. Next is enable. Default keyboard shortcut is Shift plus E. This one is very useful when you are working on B-roll footage and you're not sure which shot you want to use. For example, if I'm not sure if I want to use this shot here, then I can just select another shot and place it on the top of this previous clip. And rather than deleting this clip, I can just disable that clip. For that, you will have to right click on the clip and select enable. But instead, you can just hit Shift plus E. It will disable that clip. And if you hit Shift plus E again, then it will enable that clip. So later, if you feel like, oh, previous clip worked better, then you can easily disable the top clip and enable the previous clip. Does that make any sense? Number 3 is audio gain. Default keyboard shortcut is G for it. Whenever you want to increase the audio levels or lower the audio levels, then just select the audio clip and hit G on the keyboard to make changes in audio gain. This window will open. You can set audio gain to any particular dB. That means if you set it to negative 12 dB, see in the audio meter, maximum audio level is set to negative 12 dB. It won't cross that limit. You can also adjust audio gain by adding or removing any decibel. Like if I add 2 decibel, it will increase the audio level. See changes in audio waveform. You can also select normalize all peaks too. I generally set it to negative 6 so that audio won't be peaking. Next is speed or duration. Default keyboard shortcut is Ctrl plus R for it. So whenever you want to use fast forward effect or slow motion effect, this one comes in very handy. For example, if you want to increase the speed of this clip to show the fast forward effect, then you will have to right click on the clip and then click on speed duration. But instead, you can just hit Ctrl plus R. This window will open and then you can make changes in speed or duration accordingly. Number 5 is zoom in, zoom out and zoom to sequence. Default keyboard shortcuts for them are plus, minus and backslash. If you are not using them, that means you are wasting a lot of time. So to zoom in and zoom out the timeline, rather than using this bar, just hit plus key on the keyboard. It will zoom in at the playhead's position. To zoom out, just hit minus key on the keyboard. And if you want to see your entire sequence at once, then just hit backslash key on the keyboard. Number 6 is home and end key. If you want to go to the beginning of the sequence, you will probably move this bar and click here, right? But instead, you can just hit home key on the keyboard and then you can set your in point or make any changes there. Similarly, to go to the end of the sequence, just hit end key on the keyboard and here you can set your out point. So remember to hit home key or end key to go to the beginning or end of the sequence. Number 7 is up and down arrow key. If you hit down arrow key on the keyboard, you will be able to go to the beginning of the next clip. And if you hit up arrow key, you will go backwards. It's only selecting track 1's clips because track 1 is selected. If you hold shift and then hit down arrow or up arrow key, then it will go to every clip's beginning or end points. Next is play, forward and backward. Default keyboard shortcuts are L, K and J. J, K and L are the magic keys. Just hit L key on the keyboard to play your video. And if you want to fast forward it, then hit L key again. To stop the video, hit K on the keyboard. If you want to play it backward, then you can just hit J key on the keyboard. So rather than using mouse, you can just use your keyboard. It comes very handy when you are reviewing your video. Number 9 is render into out. There is no default keyboard shortcut is assigned for this one. So you can assign any key you want. After you are done editing, you set in and out points. And then to render your sequence, you go to sequence and click on render into out, right? But rather than doing that, you can just assign keyboard shortcut for this action. Go to edit, click on keyboard shortcuts and type render. Under sequence, you will see render into out. Click there and you can assign any shortcut key for it. If you see my default layout, I have assigned Ctrl plus H for this action. So, to render my sequence, I just hit Ctrl plus H. Last one is export and default keyboard shortcut is Ctrl plus M. When you want to export your video, you usually go to file and then select export and then click on media, right? But instead, just hit Ctrl plus M. This window will pop up. You can make changes and export your video. So after I'm done with editing, I hit home key to go to the beginning of the sequence, hit I to set in point, then I hit end key to go to the end of the sequence, hit O to set out point, then I hit Ctrl plus H to render my video. And after it's done, I just hit Ctrl plus M to export my video. These keyboard shortcuts save a lot of my time. That's it for now. If you liked the video and learned something new, then please hit the like button and subscribe to the channel. And feel free to share your comments below. I have more video editing tutorials on my channel that you can follow. Bye for now. See you next time.